इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवलाचो आज तिसरो दीस आसा, 23 तारीख आयज आसा आनी आयज फिल्म बाजारांत भरपूर क्राउड येयल्लो आसा. हांगा खुबशे सेलिब्रिटी तुमकां पळोवपाक मेळटा. अनुराग कशें हांगा पावल्ले आसा आनी तेंचेय हांगा आतां डिस्कशन आसतलें. हेच्या पयलीं आमकां आतांच आमी पळयलें की नागेश भोसले जे मराठी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री खूब नामनेचे एक्टर आसा, तेंची हांगा एक मुवी आसा, त्या खातीर ते हांगा येयले आसा. चला तर तेंच्या कडेन उलोवया आनी फुडल्या कार्यक्रमाक सुरवात करुया. ओके, आयज आमच्या बरोबर आहा गोंयातले खुबशे, गोंयान जे एवरी इयर फिल्म फेस्टिवलाक येता आनी गोंय मराठी फिल्म इंडस्ट्रीन खूब बरें तेंच्यांनी काम केल्लें आसा, इवन हिंदी इंडस्ट्रीन तेणें काम केलां, तेंच्या कडेन आयजलें.
सगळ्यांत तुमी आम्हाला प्रायमच्या टी व्ही चॅनलवर तुमचं स्वागत करतो.
धन्यवाद.
फिल्म फेस्टिवल बद्दल तुम्ही काय सांगू शकता? गोव्यात फिल्म फेस्टिवल जे
आहे, एक तर भारताचा इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल गोव्यात होतो ही फार गोव्यासाठी आणि महाराष्ट्रासाठी फार अभिमानाची गोष्ट आहे. आणि अनेक वर्ष गोवा हे इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल खूप चांगल्या पद्धतीने हँडल करतं आहे. मी गेली 2-3 वर्ष बाजारमध्ये येतो आहे, फिल्म बाजारमध्ये NFDC चा बाजार असतो आणि काही दिवस फिल्म फेस्टिवल पण अटेंड करतो. तर हे फारच उत्तम आहे, आपल्या महाराष्ट्रासाठी फार महत्त्वाची गोष्ट आहे आणि कॉंग्रॅच्युलेशन्स टू गोवा गव्हर्नमेंट आणि जे कोणी हँडल करतात.
गेल्या वर्षी आणि आता तुम्ही कित्येक वर्ष येत आहेत फिल्म फेस्टिवलसाठी, काय चेंजेस तुम्हाला वाटत आहेत, काय व्हायला पाहिजे किंवा आता इम्प्रूव्हमेंट वाटतोय की इट इज सेम एज इट इज?
नाही, बरीचशी इम्प्रूव्हमेंट आहे. सुरुवातीला काही त्रुटी प्रत्येक गोष्टीत राहतात, दरवर्षी काही ना काही मागच्या वर्षीच्या त्रुटी पुढच्या वर्षी दिसत नाहीत आणि ही चांगली गोष्ट आहे. यावर्षीसुद्धा खूप उत्तम पद्धतीने फेस्टिवल अरेंज झाला आहे. मी माझी फिल्म पन्हाळा घेऊन बाजारामध्ये आलो आहे आणि फिल्म सिटीच्या महाराष्ट्र गव्हर्नमेंटने एक 7-8 फिल्म्स स्वतःहून फिल्म बाजारात पाठवल्या, त्यापैकी एक पन्हाळा होती. मागच्या वर्षी पण मी काही 2 फिल्म्स घेऊन आलो होतो, यावर्षी पण माझ्या 2 फिल्म्स आहेत आणि इथे येऊन खूप बरं वाटतं. गोवा प्रत्येकाला आवडतं, आमच्यासाठी गोवा म्हणजे एक पॅराडाईज आहे. पण इथे येऊन इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म्स बघायला मिळतात, मजा येते.
तुमच्या फिल्मबद्दल आमच्या प्रेक्षकांना आणि काय सांगू शकता? पन्हाळा फिल्ममध्ये लोकांना काय बघायला मिळेल?
पन्हाळा ॲक्च्युली रिलीज झाली आहे पण मी ते इंटरनॅशनल मार्केटसाठी इथे घेऊन आलो आहे. पन्हाळा ही आपली आपल्या महाराष्ट्राच्या इतिहासाची गोष्ट आहे, नातेसंबंधांची गोष्ट आहे. तर इतिहास आणि नातेसंबंध ह्याचं एक सांगड आहे पन्हाळा, त्यामुळे प्रेक्षकांना ती नक्कीच आवडेल.
गोव्यात आपल्याला कधी बघायला मिळेल ती मूवी?
गोव्यात आता फेस्टिवलमध्ये आहे तेव्हाच, कारण त्याचा कमर्शियल रिलीज झालेला आहे. परत रिलीज आपल्याकडे दोनदा करत नसल्यामुळे आय डोंट थिंक गोव्यात ती परत रिलीज होईल, पण फेस्टिवलच्या अनुषंगाने ती बऱ्याच लोकांना बघायला मिळेल.
स्क्रीनिंग कधी आहे?
आता 24 तारखेला म्हणजे उद्या 11 वाजता इकडे क्यूब थिएटरमध्ये त्याचं स्क्रीनिंग आहे, तर कोणी येऊन बघू शकतं.
थँक्यू, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.
थँक्यू सो मच. थँक्यू.
आता तुम्ही ऐकले नागेश भोसलेन काय बरी गजाली आमकां सांगल्यो, खुबशे विशीज आमकां दिल्यो, गोंयांत तांकां रावपाकूय खूब आवडटा. आतां फुडलें आमी सुवातेर या, फुडें आतां आसतले स्कील डेवलपमेंट इन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री, म्हणजे फिल्म इंडस्ट्रींतल्यान स्कील आमी कशें डेवलप करूंक शकता, हेजे डिस्कशन हांगा आसा. हेजे फुडें आसतले फिल्म इन इंडिया. आमी फिल्म बाजारांत आसा आनी हांगा अपुर्वा बक्षी जी आमच्या बरोबर आसा ती सांगतली की डिजिटल फिल्म मेकींग ऑर फिल्म कारवाना हाजे कितें फायदे आसा आनी इंडियान हेजो कितें फायदो जाता. ते रिसंटली इंडिया भितरचे फिल्म डिजिटली करूंक सोदता. सो लेट अस टॉक टू हर.
हॅलो, हाव आर यू?
आय एम गुड, थँक यू.
वेलकम टू आवर शो.
थँक यू.
वॉन्टेड टू नो व्हॉट इज दिस फिल्म कॅरवॅन.
सो फिल्म कॅरवॅन स्टार्टेड 8 इयर्स अगो वेन डिजिटल, इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ डिजिटल प्लॅटफॉर्म्स वर नॉट रिली अलाईव्ह. स्पेशली इन इंडिया वी हॅव व्हेरी लो इंटरनेट स्पीड्स, बट रिसेंटली यू सी दॅट देर इज अ 4G लॉन्च हॅपनिंग. 70% ऑफ अस आर युझिंग स्मार्टफोन्स. सो वॉट हॅपन वॉज देर वॉज अ रेव्होल्युशन विथ द लॉन्च ऑफ iTunes अँड गुगल प्ले आर 2 बिग प्लॅटफॉर्म्स वर्ल्ड वाईड, राईट? सो फिल्म कॅरवॅन इज अ कंपनी दॅट वी स्टार्टेड विथ द आयडिया ऑफ ॲग्रिगेटिंग films. So it can be a Bollywood film, it can be a Tollywood film, and it can be an independent film. What we did was we started talking to all the major studios like Yash Raj, Dharma, XL, Rajshri, Shimaru, Ultra, T-Series and the TV broadcasters to take their films live on platforms worldwide. You know that there are 30 million Indians outside in the entire world, and they love Bollywood. We all love. I am based in California, and I can guarantee you that there is a huge demand for Bollywood films across the world. In the past 5 years, there has been a recent surge of independent films. Independent films money, Gangs of Wassepur, Lunchbox. You know, these are different offbeat films. Shahid, Hansal Mehta's Aligarh Now, Masaan, which went to Cannes. So these films started going to Cannes Film Festival and big festivals across the world like Toronto, and started making our films or our industry or Indian independent cinema on the map. Right, they took it to the map. The world was observing, and that's why you see in the film bazaar there are these multiple foreign delegates from across the world who come to pick up films. Right, so when this started happening, and a lot of credit goes to Anurag Kashyap to really make this happen. Right, his films were more appreciated outside in the world. You and me will love Gangs of Wassepur, but a lot of people did not really see Girl in Yellow Boots. See, Devdi was very successful. So, very pioneering actors like Abhay Deol, Radhika Apte, Nimrat Kaur, Irfan Khan, right? And Nawazuddin. Nawazuddin is every film, right? So, they started making films which were offbeat, but they became becoming more and more mainstream. So, what Film Caravan does is takes 90% of Bollywood films to the world. Yeah, so on which platforms? What is the way? We use digital V. So every film cannot release in theatres. You know, we make 1,000 films a year in India, but not all films get theatrical days. So what we do is, you might get TV deals. So you do TV deals, but at the same time, go to these legitimate platforms where it is not piracy. Internet is not piracy anymore. You and me can put our credit card and pay for a film to watch it legitimately on a platform. YouTube is free of cost to watch, but it has ads which makes you as a filmmaker money. So what we did was we started identifying platforms across the world. iTunes, Google Play, Amazon, Libara, Vooclip, BSkyB, MGo. I have 42 platforms right now on my service. We supply more than 1,000 titles to all the platforms across the world. Did you know that our films are being watched in Brazil? There's huge demand in Brazil, South Africa. There's a platform called Showmax in South Africa which we launched recently. So there was
what exactly you do?
We do is, yeah, if you are a filmmaker, yeah, and you have tried to do your theatrical, correct, and for some reason you didn't get a theatrical, which is very expensive to release in theaters. You say, I want my film to be seen. That is your objective, right? Aapne film banaya pyar mein, you want it to be seen. What we do is we will take your film and we will share it with the platforms. Platforms don't directly deal with filmmakers because they need people who can process the film. So what we do is, we'll take your film, we'll convert it into a ready-made spec for all platforms, and we'll distribute it. Platforms will receive revenue. That revenue will come through the pipeline and come back to you. We are a US-based company, and being a US-based company, we have clear auditing system. You will have access to a dashboard where you log in and see what revenue is coming from which part of the world.
Everything is clear.
Yes. We recently, earlier there was only demand for Bollywood films. Yeah. But very recently, we locked in 35 films which are going into launch in Netflix in January onwards. Great. Netflix and Amazon are coming to India next year. They are huge giants. And I think a lot of platforms are going to be very scared because they are investing a lot of money in this country.
So this is only you are doing for Bollywood films or
no,
another filmmaker like
regional
short film center, documentaries?
Yeah, documentaries. Yes, documentaries. We have Inshallah Kashmir, Inshallah Football, which have just got acquired. Ashwin Kumar is a filmmaker here. We have 2 more offers on very big documentaries from India. Short films, they are trying to create a category. It has been tough to monetize on short films, but short filmmakers should not feel bad. There is a very good time coming where short films will also reap money for the filmmaker. So we are creating legitimate way of you earning resources for making your films from the internet, which was earlier perceived to be a pirated, you know, everybody's internet was piracy. No. It's not piracy
now,
anymore.
Now this is what the fantastic thing what you are doing for filmmakers. But the thing is, how to approach you? If anybody wants to approach you, what is the way to approach you?
My best way to approach me is to go to our website called www.filmcaravan.com. We have spelled, the caravan is spelled with a K. It's right here. Okay. So best ways to reach to us through our website. We have a very big marketing agency called flixmatrix.com, which is a Facebook page. We have very strong, 100,000 members strong. You should message there, or you can reach out to me directly. I have all my details are on the Facebook, on our website. You should also understand we have a Bombay office as well in Bandra. You can come visit us. The Film Bazaar has given us a great opportunity to reach out to independent filmmakers. They are coming to the booth, they are picking up our cards. Tell your friends, if you have friends as filmmakers, they can come.
Goa, everybody is using Goa as a destiny, as a filmmaking, or Bollywood and everywhere.
Absolutely.
But Goan filmmakers are now, after looking at this IFFI, and they are like boosted up with the films.
Absolutely.
And many people are doing short films.
Right.
So how any office in Goa you have, or you are planning anything in Goa, or how Goan filmmakers...
See, we come every year. We come every year to the Goa Film Festival, to the Goa Film Bazaar and the Film Festival. If there is an association that the Goan filmmakers can make, and one person can reach out, I will personally come to their office. Or see, there is registration and all involved here, right? If you have a proper association and one representation, you can come and talk to me directly. I live in the California, but I'm here I live there for 4 weeks and I come back for 3 weeks to India. I'm in Mumbai. But if you have a conversation, to start a conversation, you can reach out to me. I will personally come down to Goa to meet with them and tell them what are the best ways to monetize on short films.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Take care.
Yeah, very new actors are coming up with that. My message is have a dream, work hard, follow your dream, keep your goals in mind at all the times. Don't do it only for money, because then it becomes, doesn't have that creative pursuit and a value factor. But have a goal and work hard towards it. Work hard. That is my main message, you know, because आमका सगळ्या ऐकायचं असतं. ऐकाय मिळणं खूप कष्ट घेऊचे पडतात. सो खूप कष्ट करा. Be confident of yourselves and learn as much as you can from whatever sources you can. Learning doesn't stop. आमकाल वचून सगळे इंटरनेट मार्केटिंग शिकून आयला. You know, electronic media, digital media. So we are learning all the time. It's a new forum for us. So I spend a lot of time here learning.
Film festival boy and other time of
It is growing. As far as International Film Festival itself is considered, it has grown by leaps and bounds. But what I am interested in is how Kokani movies are placed in that. You know, so I think
it is properly placed.
Yes, it is properly placed. And we have to produce better quality films. We cannot produce the quality films that we are producing right now and then expect a representation in the International Film Festival. Like Enemy was selected in Kolkata International Film Festival, so it just played last week. You know, so there is a niche for every film at every place. You know, so sagri film a sagri festival ami asta ashe na pratyek tanche ek moto kas asta ani ashi film ya amuk theater festival ani hota ani tashi film to amuk festival ani hota ashe asta. So ami kashta jopan ya kashta, that is only thing. Work hard.
Thank you very much. How
do you like to have a Goa as a film venue? See, Goa as a film venue is probably the best venue we have in the country. And since it's been here, I've been really happy that I hope it stays like that. I only think that I think we should be involving a lot more Goan filmmakers, local people, you know, because it remains a little bit cut off. So it would be nice to get a, you know, little feel of Goa and participate in Goan Film Festival, and probably we need to get maybe many more international celebrities to make it exciting.
I think you have done one film entirely on Goa.
Yes.
Complete Goa and crew and whatever are also involved, yeah. Which we have, you have released out of India.
Yes.
So can you just tell us about that film?
So I was very lucky to shoot Angry Indian Goddesses. Angry Indian Goddesses is a Hindi film, partly English, it's totally set in Goa. And the main character of the film is Goan, Sarah Jane Diaz, who is living in an old Portuguese house in Saligaon. And she invites, you know, her friends from all over India. And then it starts like a bachelorette party, you know. And it's a story about friendship, you know. It's a story about dostan among women. There's a lot of fun there, you know. So the film has done really well. And it will be released in more than 60 countries in 2016. Which means the Goa will be a project, you know, big screen across the world, and we are releasing here on 4th December, okay. Across India. Yeah, it will be also released in Goa.
How was the experience shooting in Goa? How was the experience?
I love it. It's always my dream to shoot in Goa, because, you know, Goa has, of course, such great locations, you know, and second, Goa has a great light throughout the year. You know, because as you know, we filmmakers, cameramen, we always want to get good lights. So, and I love the lights, especially in the evening, you know, in the morning, and some places with the red earth of Goa and green of the monsoon. It's nicely changing, and you have ocean blue and cliffs and forests and like Kankona. So there's so many things you can do with the space here. Another great thing is we use a lot of Goan crew. And in our film, first time you will see lyric and song composed by two young girls,
Swapnil,
Sankar and Ashish, have done the song, which is going to be in the film, it's going to be released on the film. And we had quite a few other Goan members, a lot of Goan extras, special actors, done special roles, and we were able to take some local teams. So, you know, every time we didn't try to bring people from outside, and always our aim is always how can we include locals. You know? And then other great advantage shooting Goa is great places to eat.
What do you think of a new movie coming in?
Right now we are just working on release of the Angry Indian Goddesses from 4th December, so it's very close, so you know, it's going to be working on that. If not, I have done another film called Beyond the Long Wall, which was shot in Himachal Pradesh, and that's currently in post-production in New Zealand. Yeah, it's a first India New Zealand film.
This is the movie which is shooting in Dubai. What is the thing that people will come to know about? What is the theme of the movie?
The theme of the movie is about friendship. It's really about the bonding, you know, how young people bond with each other. Second thing, contemporary Indianism, because it is very interesting when we were researching, many girls say that we, when we are together, there are very few destinations in India where they can travel together. You know, they will not feel safe if they go to Delhi, for example. So, you know, or we have to remain inside. But in Goa, somehow, they still feel safe that, you know, 7-8 women as a friend can go travel, go to the beach, go to the restaurant, you know, and even though, so they have that sense of freedom. So our film is set here, you know, about, inspired from the real stories where girls decide to come and share few days of friendship, but they don't know what a surprise is waiting for them, and they're just going to recount this story, you know, which unfolds, and you know, it includes many beautiful places in Goa. But it's a story of friendship.
If you can see Goa as a film city, or Bombay is the highest of Bollywood, everything is shooting is there. If the same thing is set up in Goa, do you feel that it will be a good thing?
It will be a good thing, and I want to set it up. As the my Goan crew will tell you, that's the first discussion I had. I said, can we, I'm very serious about it. And I have told that I would, first thing I want to do is even shift my post-production offices, everything here. Because, you know, what is happening in the big cities, we don't have a time, space to do creative thinking, conception. The movie is so much about creative content development. So if you are editing, why do you need to be in the middle of traffic jam? You can be seen. You know, and today with the internet, we can do a lot. So I think it would be, it's a really good time for Goa government, people of Goa to jump on and make the best studio. And I know everyone will come here. Because everyone I work with in Mumbai, they know, they all want to get here. Not one technician is happy to work. That's why, as you might have noticed, most of the films are shot abroad or outside Mumbai. So why not have, you know, great post-production facilities here, sound mixing studios in Goa, why not have a floor where we can shoot, you know, and people are definitely, you know, I believe, I'll be the first one.
Yeah, thanks so much. Last question before winding up. Basically, Goa now, it is for the filmmaking awareness is much high, and people are willingly coming out for the filmmaking, new producers, new directors, directors, everybody. What will be your message for the Goan filmmaker in Goa?
See, I was here, I was able to see two first-time Goan filmmakers' film. You know, one, they were in Konkani, I didn't understand. But I think it's very courageous. They are really doing, there's so much of talent here. You know, plus the advantage of they speak good English, Hindi, they speak Konkani. Between they can speak Marathi as well. So I think even the actors when we were auditioning, luckily, I mean, we didn't have a big role, but there were many, many good actors. Such great singers and musicians, my God. I mean, we have used music from here, from 60s of Goa, 70s of Goa. There is a very old Konkani song called Heartbreaking Song, you know, which was sang by Antoinette Mendoza, I think. Beautiful song which all the Goans know. You know, we have it in the film. So imagine the talent you have here, you know, I mean, there's everything here. There are great architects who build beautiful houses. So I think the message for Goan, some of them, when they work with me, I told them, don't rush to make this. Please, I even told the two of my people who work very closely with me, the filmmakers, Swapnil Salkar, I said, don't rush, just make a film here. You know, and I know you can make a good film here, make a Goan film that travel worldwide. So first thing is not to rush to the glamour. You know, get your root solidified. So my thing would be that we are still waiting for a first great Goan film. It is still to come, which can really shake up the nation. Like as you see, we have had some good Marathi films, you know, which has gone around the world, like Kot, and you know, I mean, many other films have gone.
You have done the shooting entirely in Goa. What are the problems you suffered or facilities? You see, technical crew Goa, I don't think there are no technical people. You have to get it from outside. So what do you actually see as a, what if you see go as a film city or editors, technical people, what are the steps what you have to take to do this Goa as a film city?
I think see, the first thing is there has to be one single window for permission. You know, we lost a lot of time, you know, trying to get permission. Then, even once you have permission, when you arrive on location, the village, panchayat, or they will say, oh no, but we don't accept this permission. So they don't even respect Goa, you know, Goa and Goa. So we are, you know, when you come from outside, so, you know, we wouldn't know what to do, you know, and someone should guide us. Or in other occasions, we were charged very heavy fees, you know, and now we don't know because there are legal fees, because who are you paying to, you know, because you go and shoot in some places and suppose you pay a fee to, and so I...
what are the steps Goa government has to take?
I think they have to make one clear window, I think, you know, and let filmmakers, because, you know, no one can do harm to Goa, you know, there's nothing bad we can do about Goa, so why there are so many rules and restrictions, you know, and there are so many beautiful places, so if they explain to people, I think it's normal to charge location fees, okay, that's fine, okay, but it should go to right place. I'd rather give it to Young Goan Filmmakers Association and make a rule. If anybody comes here in Goa, give 1 lakh rupees to Young Filmmakers Association and use that money to help your own talent. This is, many countries are doing this. If you go to countries like Sweden, you know, they have small countries. So you release an American film, some of the money you earn from big Hollywood movie goes to a local film. So you can, you know, Goa can...
There is a one type of support to the Young Filmmakers.
Yeah, yes, exactly. So it's not about giving money which could be an issue, but just getting a hassle-free permission. We really see Goa flourishing. And you know, I'm telling you, among all the filmmakers, technicians, actors, everyone's favorite destination is to Goa, to work here. Because they feel it's a working atmosphere. If they want, you go 10 minutes, you can have your calm of village life and write, develop, do workshop. You know, and that's what we really enjoyed filming here in Goa. You know, I mean, it was such pleasure to work in such peaceful Saligaon locations, you know, and which we don't have often in Bombay. We are just stressed about reaching from one place to another.
It is nice talking to you.
Thank you.
बहुत अच्छी जगह है, फिल्में देखने में अपनी है, सारी से मिलने मिलता है, शहर का
मेरे कहने की सबसे बड़ा सभी तरफ हो रहा है, तो बहुत छोटी बात भी हम चीज़ें भी सेट करते हैं, बड़ा बात है, कि फिल्म और
हमी वो है तो बेस्ट डेस्टिनेशन है, लव वो टेक्सी करती है ना
अभी आपकी पास ही हुई
है अभी बस दिल्ली में आपने
नहीं
मैं यहाँ पे एक सिंपोजियम के लिए आया हूँ दोनों के साथ इंटरेक्शन
और गोवा के गोवा में अभी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री धीरे धीरे से बढ़ रही है गोवा फिल्म
बॉलीवुड शो है तो उनके बारे में आपकी क्या राय है हमेशा बॉलीवुड से बेहतर क्वालिटी जनरेटर है अच्छी बात है
गोवा के फिल्म डायरेक्टर के लिए आपकी
फिल्म बना के रही है अपनी जमीन फिल्म जो हमारे देश में बहुत कम हो रहा है We'll be right back.